Hello, in this video we're going to see how to represent lat-long datasets and data points on a custom map background image using heatmap layers. So to illustrate that capability, we're going to do some analytics on a shop floor plan. For this, I have a picture that represents my supermarket floor plan. I have the different areas in the supermarket. And the picture I'm using here is a rectangle that is about twice as wide as it is high in pixels. Next to this, I also have data from devices in the shop that capture the position of customer carts as they move in the shop at different point in time in the day. So I have potentially lots of records here. Each of them has a unique X and Y position. And I need to represent that population on top of the image that I have on my shop. So let's go in Oracle Analytics here and let's see what we can do. If I go to Console and then Maps, I can start by simply uploading the image of my supermarket background. I just click on the image, click OK, and the image is uploaded. I can preview it, and here is my supermarket. Instead of having to create a layer at this point, I'm going to leverage a capability that is directly point information as a lat long on the image. So the bottom blue dot is a 0, 0 lat and long, and the top right blue dot marks the end of the image. So you remember our image is twice as wide as it is high. So all we have to do is to set the lat and the long for that top right blue dot to respect that proportion. Let me pick 45 and 90. And that's it. Our image goes from 0, 0 to 45, 90. Actually, it's 0, 0 to 90, 45. So all we have to do now before we visualize this data is to make sure that we proportionally reset the X and Y values we have in our file to match the 0, 0 to 45, 90 range. So that's a simple transformation. I have already done it on my data, so I'm just going to upload this. I'm uploading the floor tracker data file here, and I'm just going to make sure that the X and Y are treated as attributes in the data. And let's go and add this data set. Oh, and one more thing I forgot to do is we would like to count the records in this data set. So let me set the aggregation to count, apply script, and let's go to visualize this. So let me double click on ID, see that we have 2000 records in this data set. Now I'm selecting X and Y and pick a visualization of type map. So the system is going to generate a map. Oh, it needs to have X and Y as category because it wasn't able to recognize a lat and a long here. Okay, here are my dots. Now, I can click on the map properties here and select the background. And here are the various backgrounds. Here is our supermarket image background that we just loaded. And if I select it, it should show as a background. Here we go. Here is our floor plan. Let me delete that viz because we don't need it anymore. So now I can represent the data in various layer types. Points is pretty busy. I can't see much there, so I can use clusters, and cluster will show me groups depending on the zoom level. I can also use heatmap, which is a 5.8 new capability. Well, here I can see that the cafeteria area, bottom left, is quite busy. Now, let's even break this down a bit further by time of day. Since we have this data, I'm building a chart showing the number of records by time of day. And let me just resize this chart and go into full screen. So now, as I turn this to use as filter, if I click on the 6 a.m. to 9 a.m. time frame, oh, I can see that most of my traffic is in the cafeteria area. If I go to the evening time frame, it concentrates more on the grocery hallways. And if I compare it with the noon time frame, we're back in the lunchtime in the cafeteria area. So this is how you could use OAC to easily represent any detailed lat-long data on top of a custom image under the format of different type of layers. Thanks for watching this video.